Don't stop now. Fun's just beginning. You. Bingo. You can go now, little girl. He won't hurt you. Shame on you. So what'll it be? Quick and easy? Or the fun way?
The fun way. Say hello to my little friend.
Don't hide, Kane! The fun's just beginning!
You're going to hell.
You get him? Why is he still here?
Whoa, Rafe, he's human.
He's dead.
I know. And I killed him.
An oath sworn is an oath answered. An oath of vengeance for a life taken. A past destroyed. A future threatened. Enemy of darkness, his battle eternal, he walks the earth relentless. His mission. To hunt the messengers of evil and drive them back to hell. Now, the light of the earth depends on the immortal.
We're talking about murder here.
What are you, a doctor and a lawyer now? Besides, murder's a little too strong. Manslaughter is more accurate. Although there was malice and forethought dating back about 400 years. I eat when I'm stressed, you know that.
Look, murder is as good a word as any. I took his life.
Because you thought he was a demon. He was after that girl. He showed all the signs, right?
Right down to the brimstone B.O. Dude, don't beat yourself up over this.
He was human, dammit.
He deserved what you gave him.
If I'd have known, I would have done it differently. The girl was safe when I killed him.
I hear you, buddy. The thing about slaying demons is there's usually no mess left behind. Humans are different, very messy. You can't just walk away from that.
Drop your weapons or this man will die!
Your fight is with us. Leave him be.
Your weapons on the ground now!
Who is he commands?
No.
Not for his kind.
Let him go and fight me.
As you wish.
Thank you. job is to protect people, not to kill them by accident.
It's war. Casualties are an unfortunate side effect.
Side effect? You've never killed anyone. You've never looked into their eyes and seen the light go out.
Has he, made this mistake before?
Rafe's not the mistake-making type. Well, maybe once.
Senator, can you confirm the date of your operation?
I'm consulting with surgeons later this week, but I want the public to know that as soon as I am cleared by my doctors, I'll be getting right back to the business at hand, stopping the wholesale arms trade to third world countries and the black market trade right here. Any other questions?
Will you be ready for the meeting of Congress?
Never met a screen I didn't like.
You're just trying to gross me out, huh?
Hello there.
You think you'll live?
Reminds me of a blind date I had once.
I don't believe you. I should know. I've got instincts like a cop.
Well, Mr. Instincts, what can I do for you?
I'm a cop. Detective Garrity. Call me Sean.
Sarah Barnes, assistant examiner. First day on the job. You can call me Mrs. Barnes.
Okay, Mrs. Barnes. This John Doe, it's my case. So anything you find out, you gotta fill me in, all right? All I know right now is two uniforms found him in an alley last night. Been air conditioned by something sharp.
No other evidence?
Nothing. No ID. Well, we're checking his fingerprints through a system, but how about you guys? You find anything?
Safe to say he didn't cut himself shaving. Excuse me.
Sure.
Looks like massive internal trauma.
Anything else? Talk signature? Alcohol content?
That's all up to the ME to sort out. I'm just doing a prelim assessment.
What about all this black stuff?
It's bile.
Bile?
Yeah. Will you excuse me?
What about your assessment?
I gotta run. Pick up the kids.
Detective, who was that woman?
She said it was her first day on the job.
I've never seen her before. I was the last to know. She's probably after my job.
She also said that, this body was full of bile. Does that mean anything in particular?
Well, that's odd. And the buildup is extremely high in the sternum.
It's almost like the latter stages of rigor mortis have already begun.
What are you saying? He's decaying already?
This guy has been dead at least 3 days.
I was able to scan the coroner's report. I think you'll like this.
I thought he smelled a little ripe.
He was dead before I killed him.
3 days before, to be exact. Probable cause of death doesn't match the condition of the body. Distended sternum, bile accumulation, rigor mortis, the works.
Dead man walking, go figure. You're off the hook, buddy.
Thank you. It really means a lot.
You're welcome. I don't like to see you eaten up with guilt.
Question is, why was he acting like a demon?
You said he displayed demonic signs. Demon eyes, weird voice, temper.
Oh, yeah. He was Hellspawn all the way. And he knew my name.
Demonic possession?
Either that or a species that reanimates the dead.
But for what purpose?
Well, they only have one purpose. And it's never any good.
Progress?
Well, unconfirmed reports that the morgue security guard was admitted to Mercy General Psych Ward, suffering from shock.
Someone checked into the rubber armada, huh? Something must have flipped him out.
Or something was alive when it should have been dead.
Exactly.
Let's check it out.
Cool. I love crazy people.
It's just going to be me and Sarah this time, old buddy. I want you to cross-reference a list of demon types. Have it done by the time we get back.
Yeah, that's just fine. You guys go have your fun. I'll just stay here and work.
Work. He hates that word. Don't worry. I'll bring you a bag of cheese puffs.
Wilkins, Thomas Wilkins. He was admitted to inpatient care in the psychiatric wing. I'm his daughter.
Mm-hmm. And when was this?
Early this morning.
And who are you again?
His daughter.
To sleep, but it's no use. Can't.
I know. Listen to me. They're saying what you saw wasn't real, but it was. It was real.
It's the truth.
You're not crazy. There are things in this world that are hard to explain, but they exist.
Wasn't in my head?
No. I've seen them too.
I am family. Sarah Wilkins. His daughter, as an offspring.
Don't you mean Barnes?
Well, is it Barnes or Wilkins? Wilkins is my married maiden name. Never mind. I'll send flowers.
So how are the kids?
Looks like we're interested in the same people, Mrs. Barnes.
Are we?
Sure. Bodies that die and then go out for a stroll. People in shock trauma. Oh, there's a definite running theme here.
Yeah, well, I'll put you down for a Cop of the Year nomination.
You know, I really hate to arrest somebody as pretty as you.
On what charge?
Well, two of them, actually. Posing as a coroner and obstruction. Lying to a police officer.
Look, can't we talk about this?
No, we have talked about it. And you have the right to have a coffee with me. If you give up that right to have a coffee with me, well, a coffee will be provided for you.
Crazy broad. You got a death wish or something, lady?
Actually, yes.
Why does my gut keep telling me you can help me with this case?
Something you ate?
That body didn't die from a chest wound. It was dead long before that, right?
Dad's dead. What's the diff?
Oh, come on. All I want is the truth. No matter how out there it is, I can take it.
Okay. Decomposition level was too advanced, yes.
Well, that's what the ME said. The real ME. And now Mr. Security Guard is orbiting Pluto, claiming he saw corpses get up and walk out.
The man I examined?
No, apparently some little old lady decided she was sick of being dead, so she got up and walked out of the morgue. She tossed your dear old dad against a wall like a rag doll.
I gotta go.
Wait a second. You're not even the least bit surprised by this. Why don't you tell me who you are and why you know about
Sean, all this? Sean, you're a nice guy. But the less you know about me and what I do, the better.
Let's get one thing straight here. I am not a nice guy. The only reason I haven't booked you yet is because you've got a nose for the weird stuff that's going down here. And until the department hires a paranormal expert, well, you're all I've got.
If I'm all you've got, you're in trouble.
That's better.
Where's Rafe?
Recharging his batteries.
His body must be returned to his family. It is a price you pay for your role in his death. We will walk until we find them.
But I didn't kill him. I don't understand.
No, you do not understand. We must protect those innocent around us as fiercely as we do ourselves, even at the cost of our foolish pride.
I don't even know his name.
This death must be resolved, or you will never fully understand the value of life. The value of life.
Or the power of death.
Kungai!
Gilgo. You wouldn't know a cloven hoof from a goat's horn.
Hey, spare me the I'm older than your first ancestor speech, goody. You're wrong, you just can't admit it.
We've been hunting these freaks for 4 centuries, honey. Believe me when I tell you that this is not a Kungai demon.
Well, a Gilgul demon would never shift house so quickly. I wrote a paper on multiple possessions and transmigrating demon lore.
The Kungai are extinct.
How do you know?
Because we killed the last of them after the plague of 1792. Can the two of you please update me without the sibling rivalry? You first.
Goodwin and I agree on the fact that we're dealing with some sort of parasitical demon here.
It's your classic corpse hopper.
Well, then why didn't it jump after I killed the host?
We think it was playing possum.
Lying dormant till the coast was clear.
And a new body presented itself. And if you're shopping for a new corpse, what a better place to shop than the morgue, right? It does sound like a Kungai.
But it has to be a Gilgo.
Only because you're using archaic research methods. Who wrote that demon dictionary of yours anyway?
I did. Oh. Look, it doesn't matter. I don't care what kind of a demon it is. It has to be tracked down and killed before it strikes again. What about that cop friend of yours?
Cops. This thing won't be quiet for long. They'll keep finding evidence but not know what they're dealing with. Next thing you know, it'll be in all the tabloids.
Hey, if it bleeds, it leads, right?
That detective that's on the case, Garrity, he could give us some information, background on the victims.
Sure, because cops love vigilante demon hunters, right? No, cops ask too many questions, and they don't like any of the answers.
He's different.
Is he?
Yeah.
Because this thing has to be stopped.
We can trust Garrity.
Because?
Because we can trust him.
So when you get the message, I would really appreciate it if you could get back to me. I'd like to talk. Thanks. Bye-bye.
Voicemail?
Yeah. He'll get back to me.
You like him, don't you?
I didn't ask him to go steady. We're looking for information here, right?
Just wanted you to know that just because Goodwin and I chose our life a couple hundred years ago doesn't mean that you have to put your feelings on hold for our cause.
I don't. I like him, okay? But that has absolutely nothing to do with anything. He said he'd look the other way if I helped him with his investigation.
That sounds like a nice guy.
He is. I get the feeling that he might take my calling him as an emotional advance.
Because he likes you.
I think... I get the feeling that he might be attracted to me.
Well, of course he is.
But...
Well, he's a man, isn't he?
What is that supposed to mean?
I think I found something. It's not off the internet, but you might find it interesting. Or not.
Goodwin.
All right, laying off.
What have you got?
Well, in my profile of both the Gilgul and the Kungai, I found a common theme. Throughout history, jumping demons have always targeted people in lofty positions. Kings, clergy, the power brokers of the day.
To what end?
A higher position in society means maximum chaos.
So, whoever this demon's after will be someone in power.
And in other news, Senator Georgia Hastings will be admitted to Mercy Hospital today. Details of her medical condition have not been released, though her press secretary has released a brief statement indicating the procedure is routine and will not interfere with her duties in the Capitol. Senator Hastings is due to defend her disarmament bill when the House Committee reconvenes next week.
You think you got me all figured out, don't you? You think I'm going to spill just because I let you buy me lunch, Sarah Beckman, former professor of parapsychology, expert on the paranormal.
How did you get this?
Well, you left your prints on that bottle after we had our little chat. Well, turns out your stats are still on file after that logging protest 5 years ago. Are you gonna cooperate with me?
Sean.
Call me Detective Garrity. I've got two bodies and no explanations. The first guy gets sliced up in some alley and we find out he's already dead. So we can't call it murder. It's more like mutilation. And our second stiff, well, she just walks off the slab and then kicks some ass and goes AWOL. This is not a cut and dry case, as you can see.
So you're wondering what kind of sicko would steal dead bodies, right?
No, actually, my question is whether this is a mass possession or a specific evil entity. Now, I gotta tell you, I really enjoyed your paper on transmigratory possession lore. Some interesting theories.
I admit I have a cursory interest in the occult.
Cursory? I don't call a PhD a hobby.
Okay. There was some evidence on the first victim suggesting transmigration. However, these things are never that simple.
But it's like these corpses, they get up and they go for a walk. I know that's impossible.
Sean, I can't tell you anymore.
Well, why not? Oh, what, you're gonna have to kill me? You have no idea what I've survived. Look, it's like somebody's playing a sick little game here. I think you know the rules. You don't come across to me, I'm gonna have to arrest you. End the foreplay.
10509, what's your status?
10509, my status? Single. I like junk food, action flicks, blondes. Go ahead, Briscoe.
Unit 6 just found your missing DOA. Maybe she's your type. Alleyway north of Jasper and 2nd Avenue.
One of each for my collection. They'll never miss them.
Ah, I love my job.
Nothing like inking the rinse cycle to ruin your day.
Up to your old tricks, Harvey?
Ooh, the immortal! Go ahead and impale me. I won't run. You're no fool. Just doing my job.
Now, why would I want to waste a bottom feeder with such an important role in the underworld?
You have no idea the level of genius you're dealing with here.
Yeah, brilliant. Stealing socks.
Yeah, which takes cunning and skill. You might want to look those two words up. You should really cut down on your coffee intake, mister.
You know why I'm here, Harvey.
Fluff and fold same day service? No! Okay. Take it easy. Look. Any information you want, I don't have.
Fine. Don't tell me about the new corpse jumper in town.
Well, good. What about him?
Nothing. I don't want to know anything about him. For example, I don't want to know what species he is.
What, the Gilgai crossbreed? Well, I know what you're doing. You're not asking me questions on purpose!
Harvey, I've met geniuses like you before. Your reverse psyche isn't so impenetrable once you know how to phrase things.
No. Ask me something. Ask me anything.
But I don't want to know anything. I don't want to know anything at all. I especially don't want to know what the corpse jumping demon's going to do next. I don't want to know.
He's got a plan. He's got a big plan. Something about moving his way up the food chain, but that's all I know. For the love of Satan.
He must have jumped again.
Advance rigor mortis. Fixed pupils. But look at this. It's almost like a third degree burn scar.
while somebody burned her?
You know, ancient scholars claim the chakra of the soul is accessed through the mouth.
You want to say that in English?
Yo, Sean.
Kick her out of bed, Freedom Crushes.
Save it, okay? What do you got here?
I got something for you from Central on that John Doe the other night. Yeah, Prince and Dental make your guy a Miles Donnelly, Georgetown, D.C. He's some kind of a big shot lobbyist.
You got any handle on who this Donnelly was working for?
Some senator, I think. It's all in there.
All right, thanks, Don. You got that look again. The one you get when you're about to disappear on me?
It's an emergency.
Yeah, right. You know what's going down here, don't you?
Sean, I told you, I can't.
Sarah, I'm sorry I got in your face back there. But why don't you let me in on what's going down here? You don't have to face it alone. I promise you.
I don't face it alone, Sean. Please believe me when I tell you, you are not prepared to discover what you're after. And if you stop me now, this thing will just keep on killing.
I just don't want to find you like that.
I know.
Did you know that the hunch is a 20th century myth, first introduced by 1940s crime novels, been totally disproved by science?
Goodwin, please, just go
with me on this.
Based on what?
A woman's intuition.
Oh, perfect.
This is not a competition.
I hope you're right, because Rafe doesn't have time to mess around with guesswork.
Find Rafe now.
I know who the target is.
RV, give it up.
Who put starch in your shorts?
RV, I'm warning you. Spill one more word about our corpse-jumping demon, and I'll end your sock-stealing days forever right here, right now.
I'm just a minor league demon with a thing for laundry. What'd I ever do to you?
Oh, come now. I thought you were a genius.
Reconsider my self-image.
Having a bad day, Harvey? I hate Akvan demons.
Hey, let's not make this personal.
This backwards genius here was just about not to tell me what our corpse jumper's agenda is, right?
No, right, he's nuts. He's totally insane, even for a demon. You guys know what a Gil guy is? A couple hundred years ago, Boss got the idea to crossbreed these two demonic species. Result was one badass jumping demon. Gilgai are insane, absolutely nuts, are unhappy unless the whole ball of wax is on the line. They also have a kind of Jones thing for eating brains. It's more of a hobby, really.
Well, whatever you do, don't tell us how to flush the thing out, all right?
Yeah, Harvey, and do not tell us how to kill it, either.
You guys think you're so smart, so tough, huh? There's only one way to take it down. You gotta shock the hell out of it. Shock the hell out of it! Boo!
Sean, what are you doing here?
Well, same as you. Protecting Senator Hastings.
How did you know?
Well, our first John Doe was on her staff. My guess is whatever possessed him did it to get close to the senator.
So you buy the supernatural angle?
Well, it makes more sense than any rational reason I can come up with. Let's just nail this thing.
Okay. Welcome to my weirdness.
It's always weird.
She say she was gonna meet us out front?
Maybe she and her new detective boyfriend are busy getting to know each other.
She deserves to have a life.
Well, I never said she doesn't, but I'm just thinking, what do we know about this guy? Does he smoke? Does he come from a good family? We can't let Sarah get involved with just anybody.
Well, who said she was involved with anybody?
Not me. Hey, that must be Garrity's car.
Yeah, but who's in the cab? It jumped again.
Which means it's in the hospital.
Sarah, let's go.
Damn. They must have moved her to pre-op already.
Well, Sarah, the senator has got a Secret Service detail protecting her.
Yeah, but they don't know what we know. The killer could look like anyone.
Even a close personal friend.
Oh, no. Now, where were we? Oh, yes. The brain-eating part.
Okay, this is bad. I mean, even if we find her, she might be... Well, I mean, it might have become her.
There'd be no point, because Sarah can't help it get closer to its target.
So then it'll just...
eat her brains out.
You know, the first time that I saw you, well, I thought to myself, well, there is a girl with great frontal lobes.
You've got to be kidding.
No, I love to eat. You call it a food addiction. I love it. And brains. Yummy.
You killed Sean. You killed them all.
You know the cool thing about using one of your bodies as a hostess? Is you get to taste the memories. And this guy? Oh, he really liked you. Well, lust would be more like it. Oh, you should see the thoughts that he had about you, baby.
You're totally sick. Oh!
Well, thank you. I mean, coming from a sweet thing like you, well, that just warms my heartless cavity. Oh, well, he's dead. I guess you're not the only one that's interested in his body. You humans. You just give so much respect to people in power, don't you? I mean, right now, I'm Cloth. And that's okay. For now. But soon, I'll train up. Big time doctor. And then after that, I'll be Senator Georgia Hastings. Social mobility. It's really the American dream.
Because
the senator is trying to make herself into a hero by stopping the arms trade deal. And it ain't gonna happen. No. It ain't gonna happen. Where are you going? Where are you going?
You are demonic!
Well, duh!
And when I am finished with the Senate, people will have the right to carry hand grenades in 40 states.
What about the right to bear arms?
Kane, I thought I ditched you. What a small world.
Slippery bastard.
Are you okay?
That bastard killed Sean.
I know. We're gonna get him.
Hey, Doc. You got a minute?
Howdy-ho, everybody. Well, let's get this party rocking. I'm ready to carve. Scalpel? Hey, guys. Who hasn't dreamed of sticking it to a politician? Am I right? Huh? What have we got in here today? The B team? Come on, people. Let's get started.
Hernia's on the other side.
Oh, right. I knew that. I love my work.
Hey, Doc.
What's up?
Kill this thing.
Why don't you try this blade? It's a little sharper.
Come on.
got him.
Yeah. Just not soon enough.
Just a simple farmer.
He was a loved member of this community, elder to a large, respected family, counsel to this village.
It would have been an honor to have known him.
Always remember, no man's life is without meaning and importance. Each of us on this earth are reconnected to the other, and that connection is sacred.
Understand that now.
He didn't deserve to go like this.
None of them did.
I'm sure he was a cruel guy. I'm sorry I shot my mouth off.
How have you done it for so long? Cared about people only to watch them die.
Try not to think about their death. Remember his life and how he helped to stop that thing.
So we just go on fighting them?
Yeah, that's it. Only we do it together.
Three of us. Of one.
And one for all.